So today we are going to discuss dictionary based coding, and under this category in our syllabus we have LZW coding. 1 minute. So today we are going to discuss LZW coding, and it is proposed by Lempel, Ziv and Welch coding. Initially it was proposed by only Lempel and Ziv, and further advancement is done by the Welch. That's why this coding is known as LZW coding, and it is currently being used in GIF, TIFF and PDF file formats. Okay, so it is actually used in this file formats, and this coding also we are going to study through one example. Consider this is the given image, and we have to apply the LZW coding on this image. Okay, and this coding is going is used for the compression. Okay, so we'll see the compression ratio after applying this coding technique. So now this LZW coding comes under dictionary based coding. So we have to maintain a dictionary where we will have entry for a code word and corresponding dictionary entry. Okay, and when we recreate any image, so we will refer this dictionary entry, okay, for the corresponding code word. Okay, in LZW coding, the first entry will be occupied by our original intensity levels. So if you consider our gray image, in gray image how many intensity levels will be there? From 0 to 255. Okay, so we have total 256 intensity levels. Okay, so initial 256 entries in the dictionary will be occupied by this intensity levels. Okay, so let me draw the dictionary here. Okay, so initially for the gray image in the dictionary we'll have total 256 entries. Okay, so here we will have code word and entry in the dictionary. Okay, so for it is nothing but symbol. Okay, so for zero intensity level, so entry will be zero. Then for one intensity, entry will be 1, so up to 255. For 255 we'll have 255. Okay, and then further, as the new sequence will be generated, we'll be adding the entries in the dictionary. Okay, how that we'll see through this example. Okay, is it clear? So initial entries will be the origin will be for the original intensities. Okay, so for the gray image we have total 256 intensities. Okay, so first 256 entry will be for those intensities. Okay, so now we'll start the encoding procedure. So in LZW coding, so we have to go from the left to right and top to bottom. Okay, so in this way we'll follow. So 39, 39, 126, 126 followed by 39. Okay, so in this way we have to visit the pixel location. Okay, so currently, so first we'll visit this pixel. So for the first pixel we have not recognized any sequence. Okay, so it will be blank. Pixel being processed, currently we are processing 39. Okay, so now what we have to do, for every pixel we have to do following thing. First thing is you have to concatenate this currently recognized sequence with the pixel being processed. Now under this column we have null. Now null concatenated with 39 would be 39. Okay, so now then we have to refer our current dictionary. Okay, so now is 39 present in the dictionary? Yes, it is present initially all the intensities will be there in the dictionary, okay, and 39 will be present at the 39th location. Okay, so 39 is present. Okay, so that's why we are not going to make a new entry in the dictionary. That's why we will have null here also. Okay, then as we have not added 39 in the dictionary, so that will be added in the currently recognized sequence. Okay, so this 39 will come here. Now next pixel being processed, so it is 39. Okay, so that we have to write here. Okay, now so repeat the same process. Now we have to again concatenate the currently recognized sequence with the current pixel. So 39 39, is this combination, that combination of 39 39, present in our dictionary? No, till now we have only a single element entry. Okay, so now we have to add this pair, this combination in our dictionary. So this is the new entries in the dictionary. So what we are adding, we are adding this entry in our dictionary 39 39, and we have to specify the dictionary location. So now till now 0 to 255 locations are occupied. Next available location is 256. That will be given to this newly added sequence. Okay, so we will have 256 here. Okay, so now but before that we have to encode this single 39. Okay, as this combination was not present, okay, so we have to encode this 39. Okay, so and 39 is present at location 39, right? The indexing and elements are same, right? Okay, so first we have to encode, and that entry was not there in the dictionary, that we have added. Okay, so second pixel is processed. Now third pixel, so pixel being processed is 126. We have processed this sequence, but this element is remaining. So currently recognized sequence would be 39. Okay, this is the pixel under consideration. Now we have to do the same thing. We have to concatenate this sequence with this element. So is this pair present in the dictionary? 39 126, no. Okay, so first we have to encode this element, that is 39. Okay, and we have to add this pair 39 126. Now we have to add this in the next available location. Next available location is this one. Okay, so 257. Okay, so these are the new entries which we are adding in the dictionary. Okay, now so 39 is processed, 126 is remaining, so that is will be under sequence. Next pixel is 126. Okay, so same procedure, concatenate these two elements, 126 126. Is this pair present in our dictionary? No, so we have to process this element only, that is it is present at the location 126 in the dictionary, and we have to add this missing pair. What is the missing pair? 126, and we will assign the location, next available location, that is 258. Okay, so now this element is processed, but this is remaining, so it will go in the currently recognized sequence. Okay, next, so this is done. Next pixel is 39. Apply the same process, combine these two element. Now it is not present in our dictionary, so we have to add, but that we will do later on. First we have to encode this, that is okay, we have to write the location in the dictionary for this symbol, and we have to add this pair missing, which is missing in the dictionary, and assign the next location to that. Next, okay, this pixel is done. Now 39, so this is remaining. Current pixel is 39, this one. Okay, now we have to concatenate this pair 39 39. is this pair present in our dictionary? Yes. Okay, so we will not do anything because this, as this pair is already present in our dictionary, we will not add any entry, okay, and we will not encode it. Okay, so now currently recognized sequence is what? 39 followed by 39. Okay, we are not processed that. Next pixel being processed is 126. Follow the same, combine this to 39. Are we having any entry for 39, 136 in our dictionary? No. So we have to add that, but we will encode this sequence. Now we have to write the location of this sequence, which is 256. Okay. Now we have to add the missing and we have to assign the new location. So this pixel is done, next is 126, next pixel being processed. So this pair is processed, this is remaining, so 126. Now is this pair present in our dictionary? Yes. Okay, so we will not do anything. Okay, we need not to add the entry in the dictionary. Then the currently recognized sequence is this one. Next pixel is 39. Combine this two elements, that is 126, 126, 39. Is this available in our dictionary? No. Okay, we have 126, 39, but we don't have that. So we have to make an entry. But first we will encode this pair. So its code is 258. And we have to make the entry for this newly recognized sequence. And its code would be 261. So now this pixel is done. Next pixel is 39. Okay, these elements are processed. Okay, this is remaining. So 39. So are we having the entry for 39, 39? Yes. So we will not do anything. Then currently recognized sequence is 39 followed by 39. Now next pixel is 126. Okay. So now are we having entry for 39, 39, 126? 39, 39, 126. Yes, we are having. So skip. Then currently recognized sequence is 126. At every pixel, we are following the same process. Okay. If the entry is present, we don't add that in the newly recognized sequence. If it is not present, then we are making the entry in the dictionary and we are assigning a new code word for that. Okay. So now, so next symbol is 126. Okay. Now are we having a sequence, code word for 39, 39, 126, 126 in our dictionary? No. Okay. So first we will process this 39, 39, 126. Its code is 260. Okay. And we have to make the entry for this newly recognized sequence and its code would be this one. Now these elements are processed, 126 is remaining, and then we have 39. Next pixel is 39. Okay. So are we having entry for 126, 39? Yes, with this code. So we will not make entry and currently recognize sequence is this one. And next element is 39. Are we having entry for 126, 39, 39? 126, 39, 39. No. So we have to add that. So we will encode this. Okay. With what? 259. And we have to make the entry for this pair. And its code would be 263. Next, this is unprocessed. So 39. And after that, we have this 126. Okay, 126. Are we having entry for 39 followed by 126? 39 followed by 126? Yes. Okay, so we will not do anything. Then currently recognized sequence is this one. Next element is our last pixel, which is 126. 126. Okay, so now are we having entry for 39, 126, 126? 39, 126, 126. refer the dictionary 39 126 126. No. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to make the entry for that, but before that we will encode this with which code? 39 126, that is 257, and we have to make the entry for new sequence which is observed in our image and whose code would be this one. And finally, the all the pixels are being processed, only element remaining is 126, and we don't have any new pixel. And what is the code for 126? It is 126 only, right? Because before these are the newly added elements in the dictionary. Before this, we had total 256 entries, right? So this is the procedure of LZW coding. Any doubt? We are going to see second example also. Okay. So let us comment on this LZW. So what is the pattern here? So we have repeated sequence of pixels, and that is known as spatial redundancy. It comes under interpixel redundancy, okay, and that is being removed by this LZW coding. Okay, so first point that you can write about LZW is it addresses spatial redundancy. Second is, this I am taking from the textbook itself. Now what we are doing, we are assigning a fixed length code to the variable length symbol sequence. Okay, we are assigning now all the codes present in the dictionary. So if we are using after 256, we will be requiring 9-bit. Okay, so all the element will be coded with 9 bits. Okay, so we are using fixed length code word for the variable length symbol sequence. Now it is variable length sequence symbols, right? It is having 2 elements, it is having 3 elements, here we are having 4 elements. Okay, so the symbol sequence is varying, okay, but the length of the code word is constant. Okay, so it assigns fixed length code word to variable length sequences of source symbols, and it is actually implemented in GIF, then TIFF and PDF file formats. And last point, it does not require prior knowledge of pixel probability. This was the requirement of arithmetic coding and our Huffman coding. Okay, initially we have to calculate the pixel probability, and here it is this requirement is not there for LZW. Okay, so is it clear now? Okay, so let us see one example which is asked in the one of the university paper. Now this is the paper of Babasaheb Ambedkar Marathwada University. Now here, can you see this 4b question? Explain the LZW encoding LZW encoding technique with suitable example. Now this example is very easy to remember. Okay, so here we have only 39 39 126 126. Okay, and you can demonstrate the procedure of LZW. Okay, in next paper, it is again from the Marathwada University. Use LZW coding and algorithm to encode the 7-bit ASCII string. It is 11 times A. Now we'll solve this using LZW coding. Okay, then it will be clearer to you what is the procedure. Okay, so we have so it is 7-bit data. Okay, and the sequence is 11 times A. Okay, and okay, 7-bit means what? The initially, what would be the entries in the dictionary? So it would be from 0 to 127. Okay, and one code will be used for the A. Okay, now consider, let A equals to 65 in the so this assumption we have to make. Okay, so A equals to 65. Okay, and then we will follow our procedure. Okay, so we have total 5 columns in our table. First column is for currently recognized sequence. Okay, currently recognized sequence, and second column is for current pixel being processed, and then next one is encoded data, and then dictionary entry, and here we have dictionary location. Okay, so initially the sequence would be empty and current pixel is A. Okay, now A is already present in the dictionary. Okay, with location 65. Okay, so we will not add a new entry in the dictionary. Now A is unprocessed, current pixel is A. Okay, so we'll be having 11 entries here. Okay, we have 11 A's. Okay, now are we having an entry for 2 A's in our dictionary? No. So we have to add that, but before that let us encode this A. So we'll have A at 65, and that is our assumption. So clearly mention your assumption, and we have to add this pair. So A and the next available location is 0 to 127 are occupied. So next available location is 128. So the location would be 128. Now this A is processed, remaining element is A. So A, this will come here. Next pixel is A. Are we having entry for AA in our dictionary? Yes. So we will not do anything. So currently recognized sequence is AA. And next symbol is A. Are we having entry for 3 A's now? No. So we will first encode this. Okay, and we have to make the entry for 3 A's, and its location will be 129. Now A is unprocessed and new pixel is A. Are we having entry for AA in our dictionary? Yes. So we will not do anything. Okay, so these two are unprocessed. Then next symbol is A. Are we having entry for this 3? Yes. So we will not do anything. So current sequence is AAA. Next symbol is A. Okay. So are we having entry for 4A? No. So first we will do the encoding. So AAA code is 129 and we have to make the entry for 4A and its code would be 130. Now A is unprocessed and current symbol is A. Are we having entry for 2A? Yes. Okay. Then next symbol is A. So how many are done? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 are done. Okay. So are we having entry for AAA? Yes. So next symbol. So 10 are done. So are we having entry for 4A now? Yes. Okay. So we'll write here. And this is the last symbol. Okay. Now, are we having entry for 5A's? No. So we have to encode this with code 130. Okay. And we have to make an entry for newly recognized sequence. And now A is unprocessed. So we'll write here. Now there is no more symbol. Now let us encode A. It would be 65. Okay. Because A is present in the this location. Okay, so now initially it was like this. So if we encode this given string, so it was like this 65 65 65, okay, element times. Now after encoding, it is encoded as 65 followed by 128. Then 129, 130 and 65. Okay. Now how compression is achieved? Now there are 11 elements and each was having 7 bits. So this was the bit requirement initially. And now we have added this range 128 to 256. So now every element will have, will require 8 bits now. Okay, but how many elements are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so now you can see the compression ratio. In our previous example, if you do the calculation, total number of pixels will be 4 into 4, that is 16, multiply by, it was a gray image, so 8 bits. From there, okay, so how many elements are will be there in the encoded data? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 multiply by, and each is requiring 9 bits. Okay, so you can calculate the compression ratio like this. Okay, so that is the idea behind LZW coding. Okay, so if you see the repeated pattern, okay, so we can use a new symbol for that. Okay, is it clear to you? Any doubt? I could find only these two questions based on the LZW. Shall I repeat? Okay, so with this, our third unit is also over. Only one point is remaining. We have not discussed problem based on run length coding. Okay, that we'll see later on. Okay. Okay, so please mark your attendance. So in the next lecture, we are going to start our fourth unit, which is based on segmentation.